Hello, hello, welcome back. I am so glad you're back today because I am going to show you what products I am going to pen for the Team Project Pen 2020. This project pen is created by Kat and Haley from Beauty News. They have introduced their project, I think, like a week ago. And I think only Kat has really introduced the product she's going to pen, and I think Haley will be doing the same in the coming few weeks. If you want to check out their channels and the video introducing this project pen, then check the description box because I linked their channels, the Beauty News channel, and their videos down below, so you can easily find them there. Also, before I jump in, I want to make a few disclaimers. The first thing is that I won't be penning anything I totally don't like, because if I have a product that I'm disliking a lot, I'm just going to give it away or toss it. I am not going to be trying to pen something I don't enjoy using. I think life is too short. My collection is too big for that, so I'm not going to do that. I did a project pen, the Team Project Pen 2019 last year. I even started with 3 projects. It was my first year project penning, and I got a little bit carried away, I think. So I did 3 projects, and I discovered that I like project penning. It's just not something that is totally on my mind all the time, and it is really something I don't really get the buzz from, really penning a product or hitting pen on a product. It's like sometimes it's a bit of a chore. So what I did for this year, firstly with the product I am not going to use if I don't enjoy, those are not going to be in there. Also, I have made specific goals for every product, and not every goal is going to be using it up. Sometimes I am saying, okay, I want to use a gram of this, or I want to use an X amount of centimeters before I go and take it out of the project. Also, what I really love about this project is that you can swap your products every 3 months, so that keeps it nice and fresh. Also, and that is the last thing before we jump into the video, is I'm wearing everything I'm going to pen on my face because I wanted to get a feel for how they perform and how the products perform and what I like and what I don't like. And I already have some feels, and I already know a few things that are going to be swapped out in a few months, but you know, we'll get to there when we get to there. Let's just jump into the video, guys, and let's see what I'm going to pen this year. And yeah, I'm excited. I am starting with the first product on the list Haley made. There's a spreadsheet Haley made. I catered it a little bit to my own preferences. But yeah, she made a beautiful spreadsheet where you can really keep track of your product and how you are doing. And I'm going to start off with primer because that's the first thing on the list. And my first primer product I want to pen is this Versace Skin Tune Blur. It's in a mini. I want to use it up. The goal is to use it up. And I am at 37.5 grams right now. The reason why I chose this is because I want to see what it does. I have bought it when I went to London, and I have been using it a few times, and I don't dislike it. It's just that I haven't formed an opinion on it yet, and it's not a very cheap product. The mini is like £22, I think I paid for this, and that's like 25 euros, I would say. And the big one is like 54 euros or dollars. It's, I don't know which currency you're using. Yeah, so I want to just know what this product does for my skin, if it's any good, and if it's worth the money, frankly. The next primer is going to be the Clarins SOS primer in the shade 02. That's the peach shade. I bought this primer because I heard Rachel from Rage Love rave about this one. So I got it, and I don't really enjoy it that much, or not as much as I hoped I would. I think the applicator is quite nice because it's a pump and a squeezy tube, so that's easy to take with you. But I don't know if you can see, but it gets really grimy around the sides, and just that just bugs me. And the product itself, it's nice, it's okay, but it's the same with the Farsali. I haven't really noticed any benefits to longevity of the makeup or applying of the makeup or evening out my skin tone. And I want to really make a point of getting to know this product a little bit more. And my goal is to use it up because I think it would be better to have it out of my collection than in, the way I'm feeling about it right now. So my goal is to use it up and I am at 41.3 grams at the moment. The next category is foundation, and for my first foundation I am going to try and decide in the coming 3 months if I want to keep this or if it's going out of my collection. It's the MAC Waterweight foundation with SPF 30 in the shade NW18. I'm wearing it today and this is one of the products I'm like, you're giving me some sort of a feels. It's like a very light coverage. It's not like a BB cream type of coverage. It gives you coverage. It's just very light. And I want to see how it performs on my skin. Right now, I am feeling like it's settling into pores a little bit too much. And I use it with the Skin Tone Blur from Versace and the Peach Primer. I don't really enjoy how it's sitting on my skin today. So I really have to see in the coming few months if I want to keep this in my foundation stash or if it's going to go. Then for my next foundation or my other foundation, because I don't want to have a foundation in here, just the one, because I didn't know who was going to like the water weight. So I want to pan, is it true? Yeah, I want to hit major pan. That's my goal, hit major pan. It's in my spreadsheet on this Studio Fix from MAC. It's this, just a powder foundation. I really enjoy this product. It's a nice product, especially when I want more of a lighter day. So I really enjoy this one. This is in the shade NW20, and I think it's a tad bit light for me. So I want to try and hit that big pan right now, because we're in winter, and when I get a little bit more of a tan, then I really need to up the shade. I have NW22 and I have a feeling that that is an okay shade for me in winter as well. So this is just, yeah, I want to pen this. I have made quite a dip on it already. I don't know, I can't really show this. Quite a big of a dip in here already. What I'm doing with this one, I am weighing it and I'm taking pictures, but when the dip, when there's no pan, it's not very easy for me to show you the progress. So I've also weighed it and it's 60 grams right now. And I forgot to tell you, the MAC Waterweight one is 116.2 grams. So yeah, this is the second foundation I am trying to hit major pan on. For concealer, I have two concealers. One you've already know because I have tried to pan it last year, and that is this one, the Maybelline Eraser one in the shade Fair, and this is the Age Rewind one, and this is where I am at the moment, and it weighs 20.2 grams right now, and my goal is to use it up. So that's one concealer, and then the other one is the Maybelline Fit Me concealer. Sorry, I'm saying that a little weird. And that is this one. And it is in the shade 16. Yeah, and I have a feeling it's a bit too yellow for me. So I want to see how I can make this work. Because right now it's a bit too yellow. I don't mind the consistency. I kind of enjoy the consistency at the moment. So yeah, I want to see if I can combine it with maybe more of a corrector, peach corrector, and then just a small amount of this, or just trying to combine it with the eraser because that's a little bit lighter and a little bit more pinky toned. So yeah, I want to try this and see what I feel. And the goal for me with this one is to decide if I want to keep it after 3 months or if it's going out of my collection. So I am really just going to see if I can make it work for myself and if I like it. I am quite at the beginning. As you can see, I marked it. I think it's about right here because it hasn't settled fully. So I think it's around here. And I also weighed it. So it's 16 grams at the moment. So yeah, that's the second concealer I'm going to try to get some use out of this year. Then for powder, I am bringing an oldie back. I think if you have followed me in my previous project pen, you've seen this in the beginning of the year. I was trying to at least use this a lot before I swapped it out. I swapped it for another one. And this is the Maybelline Master Fix. And my goal right now is just to use it up. I have weighted and I put down a mark. And I'm trying to always keep it upright, shake it a bit. But yeah, it always... Nah, well, I am right here right now, but I used it today and I'm already here. But the thing with marking it like this, I have a feeling I don't always... have the container the same way up, even though I try to keep it as straight as possible with the logo and everything, but still it doesn't work. So I have also weighed it, and it's 35 grams right now, and the goal, as I said, is to use this one up. The next category is setting spray, but I don't have a setting spray at the moment. I want to pan because I don't have a lot of setting spray. I'm doing good in that department. I'm not buying too much and there's not too much coming into my collection at the moment. So yeah, I decided not to put in a setting spray because I use them up quite organically at the moment. But I have two bronzers I want to work on. Both are oldies but goodies. You've already seen this one. This is the CoverGirl Vitalist Healthy Powder in Buff Beige. This is quite a light bronzer. It's technically not a bronzer. It's technically, I think, a setting powder or finishing powder. For me, this is quite a perfect wash of bronzer color. So yeah, I really enjoy this product. And I just want to use it up until I have to repress. So if I have a feeling like, okay, I can't pick up enough anymore, then and I have to repress to make sure that I can, then I'm going to see if I'm going to take it out of my collection or if I'm going to try and repress it. I don't know if you've seen, oh no, you haven't seen my empties, it's coming up, but I'm not that good at repressing, and you will see why I'm saying that in that video, but that will be coming up after this, I think. And the other one I'm trying to pan is the Hoola bronzer. That's also one I was working on last year. This is the mini. I took it out of the packaging because it was hella annoying to get to it, to get to the product. So I took it out of its packaging, and right now it is at 8.4 grams. And my goal is to use it up until I have to repress. So it's the same with the other bronzer. I enjoy this one, and I just want to see if I need to buy a full size of it or if I'm okay with the Hoola Light, because I also have the Hoola Light in my collection. For blush, I also brought back an oldie but a goodie. This is the Dandelion blush I was working on last year. I took it out because I got sick of it. So I swapped it for the Milani blush. I think that is going to be given away because I don't like that, but you can watch my finale if you want right up here, and I'm telling you why I didn't like that product. But this is something I really like, especially in winter. It is a very light shade. It has a bit of a glow to it, a bit of a subtle golden glow to it, but it's not as extreme as the Milani one had. So I really enjoy this product and I want to use as much as I can until I have to repress. And then I will see what I'll do. I think there's a... I don't think I can show you very well, but there's a bit of a tear right here. You can't really see it, but I think that chunk is going to fall out. So yeah, I'm going to see how far I get before I have to repress it. And then I'm going to decide if I will repress it, yes or no. Then for highlighter, I brought in two new products. I brought in the Wet n Wild. This is the Blossom Glow in 319B. This one. Hope you can see it. It's a very light, very champagne-y, pinky, rosy. I don't know. But what I want to achieve with this one is just to get to know it better. So I have to use... 1 gram. I kind of stole this idea from Haley. Haley is doing something with her or a project. I think she's going to put it into her Team Project Pen, but she is trying to use a certain amount of grams in eyeshadow palettes she hasn't used up until now. And I think she wants to use 1/4 gram on each product. And I thought, well, maybe I can just do the same, but take 1 gram. I don't know if that's too much. I don't know if it's too little. I don't know how quickly or how long it will take me to hit that goal, but I want to try it out. So I just took 1 gram as a reference point, and I'm just going to see what happens in the coming 3 months and see how much I can use up in these 3 months and if I want to swap it out, yes or no. And that's kind of the same with the next highlighter. I wanted to have two because I don't want to get bored. And I just pulled an oldie but a goodie. This is the Catrice. Not that you can see it on the front because the name has totally worn off. But this is a Catrice highlighter in the shade Light Infusion. And as you can see, it's a very light highlighter. It's a baked formula. What I need to do is not to bring it too far up to my cheeks because it can give a bit of a grayish grayish cast to it. I don't know why, but because it's extremely light, as you can see. Yeah, so I don't know why it does that, but I kind of enjoy it and I want to try it a little bit more. And I have done the same thing for the goal that I set myself with this product as I did with the highlighter from Wet n Wild. I want to use up 1 gram. For eyeshadow primer, I am decided that I want to use this MAC paint pot in soft ochre. I already had major pen on this, so I think I will be able to pen this in the coming 3 months. And the reason why I chose this product is because I love the product. I love what it does for canceling out my fine lines and the color discoloration on my eyes. And I like that it has this yellowish tone, so the eyeshadows that I put on top of it is going to stand out and be really bright. You see the colors very nicely. The only thing I don't really like about it is the texture it gives my eyelids. So what I want to do, I want to get the Anastasia Beverly Hills eyeshadow primer. But I don't want to get that before I finish this because I don't have a lot of eyeshadow primers. I have the same one as this. Or the paint pot in Paintly. So I have 2 of these and that's it. So I don't have a lot of eyeshadow primers. But I don't want to buy another one before I pen this one. So I want to pen this one and then I can get the Anastasia one. The next category is eyeshadow or eyeshadow palette. I am not going to pen an eyeshadow palette. That is totally not what I want to do. That is something that is not appealing to me. So I decided to pull a few singles. And I have a few different goals for each one of them. So I'm going to tell you as I go along, showing you what I wanted to say about eyeshadow palettes. What I am going to do is a shop my stash type of video series here on my channel. And I'm going to put my eyeshadow palettes in there. So I want to get use out of my eyeshadow palettes. And I did that last year by pulling 2 new eyeshadow palettes, or sometimes a face palette as well, into my project, use them for a month and then tell you what I thought. And I really liked that. So I think I'm just going to do a shop my stash type of style video, or just a shop my stash. It's not style, it's just a shop my stash video. And I'm going to put the eyeshadow palettes in there. So let's get into the eyeshadows I want to pen. I have a lot of these small single whitish type of eyeshadows lying around. On this one, I have a teeny pinprick type of a pen at the moment. It's one from NYX. I know it's from NYX. I have no clue what shade this is because it just says MMMNOW or N0W. I have no clue which one this is. The thing is with this one, it sets my eyeshadow primer perfectly, but it doesn't have a lot of opacity to it. So I can't use it as a eyeshadow to really have, the color doesn't show up enough for me to use it in a look. So I'm going to use this up. This is the goal. Use it up until I have to repress. And at the moment it weighs 2.5. I also take pictures of this one and I have a teeny tiny pen, but I can't show you. I'm trying to show you, but I can't show you. So yeah, this is one of the eyeshadows I want to pen. Then I have this dusty pink, very cute eyeshadow I bought in New York in a Korean skincare and makeup store I came across. And I want to use 1 gram of this one. I am at 17.9 grams at the moment and I want to use 1 gram and I want to see what I think of it and if I like it, yes or no, if I'm going to keep it or if I'm going to toss it. It's not that old. I bought it in October last year. No, that's not true. October the year before. It's not extremely old. I just never used it. So I think I would get good use out of this. And then the second one or the third one I am going to put in my project is this one. It's the One from Douglas is a single shadow. This has been in my collection for years, but it still works. It still works. It's opaque enough to really show up on my eyelids as a lighter color. So that is why I really like to keep using it, because it still works. And I think it's a nice combination with this color. So yeah, and it's already, there's already quite a dip in it, because I really used to use these type of colors when I did my makeup back in the day, when my collection wasn't as big as it is right now. And this one has a goal of hitting pan. And then the fourth one, because I was using it today, the two eyeshadows I was using today on my eyes, I like the combination, but I couldn't deepen it up enough. So I pulled out a fourth one, and this is also really, really old. I think this is something I used in conjunction with this back in the day. This is the L'Oreal. It's L'Oreal 153 in Prune Metal, or Metal Plum. Metal Plum, that was the French name. It's in Metal Plum. So it's the L'Oreal, and it's in the Color Appeal Platinum range. I have no idea if that still exists. This is oldest, but it's still, it still works. So I'm going to use this until I take the rest out. So I took a picture, and I didn't weigh it yet. I'm going to. Didn't weigh it yet. This is just a companion for the other two eyeshadows. And I'm just going to see how much I can use up in the time it takes me to hit the goals I set for the other two eyeshadows. The next category is a liquid or gel eyeliner. And this is also a familiar one for you if you have been following me. I'm going to just keep working on the L'Oreal L'Oreal Gel Intensa Eyeliner in Pure Black. These names. Oh, I already hit a little bit of a pen in the middle. I can't really show you because it's, you know, I hit pen and then I was like, yeah, but it's like a tunnel to the pen. And I want to work on the sides right now. I'm just happily plodding along with this one. I think it's going to take me maybe a full year, maybe more to pen this one. But it's a nice eyeliner. It's drying up a little bit, so I want to use it before I can't use it anymore. And my goal is to use it up. Oh, and I am at 29.8 grams at the moment. All right, then we go into eye pencil. I didn't pen an eye pencil last time, but I wanted to pull one in right now. And I found a very old one. It's a Max Factor pencil. It's in the shade, I think, just brown. Yeah, in 030 brown. And it still works really well. Even though there's not even a cap on here, and there hasn't been a cap on there forever. I want to use it until the Max Factor writing is gone. So I want to use this much, because then the Max Factor writing is gone, and then I am going to call it quits, because I have to hold it very well to be able to sharpen it, and I don't think I can be... I won't be able to hold it well enough to sharpen it, and then I think I would have gotten good use out of this one. So I am going to go until I have sharpened the Max Factor part off. I am keeping track of the centimeters as well, and I am at 9.2 at the moment. I don't think I took a picture, but I don't know for sure. Then for mascara, same thing. I'm going to try up this Clinique High Impact one, and this is the one I only use on my lower lashes, because it doesn't work for me on my top lashes. And I'm going to use it until it dries up. I am at 19.8 grams at the moment. Another oldie but goodie, the MAC Shape and Shade Brow Tint in Taupe. This one. It's the one with the felt tip. And I believe not powder, but pomade type of deal in here, because I put in my... I don't use this thing because if I drag the sponge through my eyebrows, it takes hairs with it. I don't want that. So what I'll do, I'll just take a Sigma E65, I believe it is. Where is it? I just take the E65 from Sigma, and I use that to draw in some color. I like this product a lot, and I want to use it up before it dries out. So I'm going to use it until the tip dries out, I think. Yeah, until too dry to use. So this thing, the felt tip thing, if that gets dried up, if it goes bad in any way, shape or form, I'm going to call it quits on this one. This time I didn't choose a brow setting product because I have only two in rotation. I have a clear brow gel and I have a color brow gel. And the color brow gel is from Benefit. I love that one. And the clear one is from the Brow Gel brand. And I'm just seeing if I like that, yes or no. So I don't feel the need to pen anything because I don't have too many in my collection at the moment. Then for lip liner, nothing special here. Also, I really enjoy using this one. It's the NYX Suede Lip Liner in Whipped Caviar. I enjoy this one, so I'm just going to work on this more. I'm going to check the goal. My goal is to use up, so it's the same with the Max Factor one. Once I am not able to sharpen this one anymore, I'm going to call it quits. But for now, I'm doing good. It's 8.3 centimeters. And what I did, I have a lot of lip products in my project this time. And I tried to choose some products that will go well with this, so I will use it. And the first lip product I have is this, it's lipstick, because the next category is a lipstick. And I've chose this mini from Bite. It's in the color Date. And I think I'm going to swatch it all for you. So I have the lip liner. So I can show you what I mean. In front of my face. This is the lip liner. Then this is the Bite one in Date. It's a little bit more orangey, but I think it will be okay to use them together. This is 1.9 centimeters at the moment. I'm going to keep track of the centimeters. I just want to use this one up. It's a small one I got in a Christmas pack, I think last year. It was that red tin with four minis. I got this one from a lovely friend. She took it for me, or brought it from me when she was in Washington. I can't get to buy it like at all. I have to be in America or Canada to get to it. So yeah, I was really, really happy she took that for me, and I want to use them. So that is the reason why I want to pan this one. And my goal is to just use it up fully because it's a color I really enjoy. It's just sitting in my collection and I'm not taking it out enough, so that is why it's in here. And also, I am going to New York at the end of August, so if I really enjoy this color, then I will be able to get a full size then, but I have to get a feel for it. So that is why this one is in here. For the lip gloss, I have chosen the Honey Lacquer from Max Factor. This one, also a color that goes really nicely with the lip liner, I believe. And I think it's a nice color. It's really right up my alley. It's pinkish, but it's kind of a dusty pink. And it even has a bit of an orange tinge in it in person. So I really enjoy that one. And I haven't put in a lip balm, but I have put in a liquid lipstick. And this is the Mini NARS Lip Glide in Roseland. I don't know if it's technically a liquid lipstick, but it's something that comes close for me. I'm wearing it right now. I really enjoy using this, but it's a mini, so I want to, it's not the best swatch ever, but it's the last one. It's this one. It's a very nice texture, and it dries down matte, but it feels really light and balmy on the lips. It's a mini, so I want to use it up because I want to know if I want to buy the full size or if I want to try more colors in the range. But this is, I have been using it for a few days now, so I want to get to know this one. And that is the goal. Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't tell you. I'm sorry. The lip gloss is weighing 26.2 grams. My goal is to get to know it. So I'm going to use it for 3 months and I'm going to see if I like the formula, if I want to get more colors. And that's the same with this one. It's just that I want to use this one up because it's a mini, but I want to get to know the formula because it's quite new to me. So I want to get to know this more and see if I want to get it in more colors. And it weighs, I have to see, 19.6. grams at the moment. Yeah, and that's all I need to tell you. Then I even brought in a nail product, And that is this one. It's the Herome Nail Hardener in Extra Strong. I am here. So as you can see, I need to get some more use out of this one. The reason why I picked this product is one, because I haven't been using it in quite a while. I bought it because I wanted to strengthen my nails for my wedding. My wedding was in May last year. So yeah, it's been sitting around. It's getting a little bit of a weird... see, you can see the cloudiness. So I want to use it up because it's a very nice product. And also, I'm neglecting my nails. Look at my nails. I'm totally neglecting them at the moment. So yeah, it's kind of beneficial for one, my nails, and two, to get some use out of this one. And I think that my goal is to use it up. So high goals. It is 43.1 grams at the moment. So we will see how fast I will go. I don't think I will go very fast. The next thing on the list is fragrance. And I decided to work on my minis. I can actually close it now, so I'm quite happy. I have some minis in here and I want to use everything up. So I'm going to try and not get more minis into my collection. Only the ones I really want to try. And the rest I'm just going to give away or just ask them to give me something else instead in store. But yeah, I really want to work on these. I am at 14 in total at the moment, and my goal is to have only 5. And the reason why I said 5 is because I have 3 Jo Malone minis and 1 Tom Ford mini that I just want to use on special occasions. And I think that if I have one other, there would be a healthy amount of minis. So that is why I want to use up at least 9 so I can be at 5. But yeah, if there's new stuff coming in at the end of the year, I can only have 5 of these. So yeah, wish me luck on that one. I have 2 body products and these are going to be very easy for me to pen. The first one is the Nivea. Like this. No, like this. Like this. The first one is the Nivea cream. I'm seeing myself in the viewfinder of the camera and it's upside down, but it's just in mirrored reflection, if you know what I mean. So this one is the first one I want to pen. I found this. It's very bumped up and grimy. And there's a little bit left. And somehow I'm not using it up. So I want to use this one up. And I'm using this up by putting it on my feet every evening before I go to bed. Use up is the goal and I am at 20.1 grams right now. And I have the same type of a product here. It's the Nivea Soft Hydrating Cream. I don't know if I can show you. I can't really show you because it's just too wide of a container. So I don't think I can, but there's not a lot of it left. It weighs 81.5 grams. It's just sitting there in my nightstand and I want to use it up same way as the Nivea cream. I think the other one is going to be gone within a week. This one is going to take me a little bit longer, but I want to get rid of it because yeah, I think it's just a bit of a waste. Is my lighting the same? I think it's just wasteful to have it lying there and I don't want to have a lot of these body creams lying around without me using them. So yeah, this is for me, yeah, just a way to make sure I don't have that many in my collection. Okay, we are at the last category I have a product in, that is skincare, and I'm going to try and pen the Ordinary Caffeine Solution 5%. That is this thing. This claims to reduce the appearance of eye contour, pigmentation and puffiness. I have been using it on and off because I don't really feel like it does that much. I marked it right here. I've also weighed it. It is at 64.1 grams at the moment. And the goal is to use it up because it's an okay product. It's just not doing as much as I would have hoped. And that is maybe because I have too high hopes for it. I don't know, but I want to get it out because yeah, it's not a bad product. It's just not really that working for me. And the last thing is a hair product. I chose not to put a hair product in because I go through my hair products quite organically. There's nothing in my stash at the moment that I want to get rid of, or is just taking up space and me not using it. So I decided not to put anything in that category. So that is everything. These are all the products in all the categories. If I forgot to put in some grams and stuff, then I'm sorry. But yeah, you will hear the progress I made on them in the update videos. I do one every month, and I think I will be doing them in the last week of every month. So that's why this introduction came in a little bit later, because I want to put these videos at the end of the month to spread out the videos I make a little bit more than I have been in the past. So yeah, guys, thank you so much for watching. Let me know if you are joining this Project Pam, because I would love to follow your progress. Give this video a thumbs up if you liked what you saw, and subscribe if you haven't already. And I hope I will see you in my next video. Bye!